we can, you know, we can keep pushing on your vulnerabilities so that we can really break them out and, you know, get back.
So who was the next story?
Okay, so what I see is, I see that you work with a lot of children. So, you know, you never worked with job after your studies?
That's right, I'm only a child. It's my job.
That's right, but there, any other job?
No, this is my job.
This is your job, yeah. So, quite unfortunate. Because the society is going in the opposite direction.
Okay.
So what does it mean? Which means, you know, you will be socially alienated because you're still, in some ways, you're still being in a good balance.
I get it.
Okay. You know, there was a man who had a... so there was a man who had a nice nose, you know. He went to a village where everybody had an ugly nose. You know, partially school, you know, kind of school. And this guy went down and he looked at everybody. Everybody started laughing at him. He said, hey, I need to know. You know, what happened to your nose?
Okay, so this has happened.
Okay.
I would say, because when I chose this profession initially, so it is a professional degree course of 4 years. So when I chose this after my 12, I had so many people around me who actually laughed at me. Oh, you can't write engineering, you can't write medicine, that's why you chose this. All these kinds of things. And but I stuck to my word. I said, no, I want this. I want to work with people like this one single. So that's how I chose it. And even after completing my graduation, I was working here in a pediatric clinic again. I worked only with kids. I love kids so. And adults, it was more difficult for me to work with adults. It was too much of an emotional stress. I had done both, but it was too much of an emotional stress for me when I took adult cases. So when I actually took the, when I was working here and suddenly because of some reasons I had to move back to Kerala, again it was, you know, the closed mind was set up. Oh, what is she going to do after coming here? Is she going to sit idle at home? Is she going to get some work here and all those stuff? But it's been only 5 months and I already have 13 kids coming to watch me. So I don't feel like out of the world, but when I talk to the parents of such kids, they understand the need. So even if the society doesn't or the people next door doesn't understand what I do and what I, what I build in the, those kids,
they will be enough tension in it.
Definitely, when I actually work with certain kids, I'm very tense before their session. I don't know what I should do, you know, challenging cases.
That will all go away with time. Because the more sessions you do,
right,
the more you feel confident and, you know, you'll be okay with them. But this would be a real issue, which is about, you know, connecting people on being yourself. Because, you know, if you don't have a target, if you are not running after something, if you are, you know, just saying I'm happy, then you can't tolerate.
That's not my problem. If you can't tolerate.
No.
Right, no?
Yeah.
See, I myself am happy, so
yeah.
I don't
have to. But you're going to live in a house where there's going to be a father-in-law, mother-in-law, and husband. So, you know, it's really important to communicate that you are really, you know, doing some best of the work that you need. You've reached the pinnacle of what you want.
Okay, so I would like to share this too, because my dad wasn't so happy in me doing this. He always discouraged. When I went for the course, he didn't have a choice. He couldn't say no. He said, okay, it's your wish, you do whatever.
So you're quite a rebel, you know. You look very free and happy, but you know.
When it comes to this profession, it does sometimes trigger me.
But we say that, you know, only people, you